Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to your online English grammar class. Students, in my previous session, I have started new lesson, that is lesson number 8, the adjectives. Okay, I explained you all that what are adjectives and what are the different kinds of adjectives. Okay, so in my previous session, I have explained the first three kinds of adjectives, that is adjectives of quality, adjectives of quantity, and adjectives of number. Okay. What is adjective of quality? Adjective of quality tells about what kind of person, place, or animal or thing is. Okay? Then adjectives of quantity tells about the quantity of how much. Okay? How much the person or how much the thing is meant to be. Okay? And adjectives of number tells that how many person, place, or thing is indicated. Okay, so these are the kinds of adjectives which I have explained in my previous session. Okay, now today I am going to explain you that what are demonstrative adjectives. Okay, what are demonstrative adjectives? Now see children, four words, this, that, these and those. Okay, they are demonstrative adjectives if they point out person, place, animal or thing. Okay. This, that, these, those are the words, are the adjectives, okay, which point out certain person, place, animal or thing, okay. Then these four words are said to be demonstrative adjectives, okay. These adjectives are always used before noun, okay. They always point out person, place, animal or thing, so they are always used before noun, okay. Now, I have written four sentences here, children. So, let's see these four sentences. What are the demonstrative adjectives in these four sentences? Okay. The first sentence is, this book is mine. Now, see children, here in the sentence, this word this, okay, is pointing out this book in the sentence. Okay, book is what? Book is noun. Okay, so the word this is pointing out this book. Okay, so word this is demonstrative adjective. Okay, these four words, this, that, these, those, okay, they point out as they point out certain a person, place, animal or thing. Okay, so they are known as demonstrative adjective. Okay, now in second sentence, these books are yours. Now here again you can see children that these is pointing out the books. Okay, that these books are yours. Okay, books is noun here. Okay, and this word is pointing out at that noun. Okay, so these is what? It's demonstrative adjective in this sentence. That car is small. Now here again, that is pointing out at the car, which is thing, which is noun. Okay, so again, that is what? It's demonstrative adjective in this sentence. Those grapes are sour. Now again, this word those is pointing out at the grapes. Okay, so word those is what? It's pointing out at noun. Okay, so it's demonstrative adjectives. So in these four sentences, children, this, these, that, those, these four words are demonstrative adjectives. Why? Because they are pointing out at person, they are pointing out at different things in these four sentences. Now one more thing, children, I want to tell you that this and these, okay, they are, these two words are used to point out a person, place, animal or things which are nearer to the speaker. For example, this pen, okay, this chalk. So these two things, they are nearer to me. I'm the speaker and they are nearer to me, so I'm using the word this, okay. Now, and always remember that this is used for pointing out at singular, person, place, animal or thing. These is used for pointing out at plural, means more than one person, place, animal or thing. Okay. That and those, they are used for pointing out at things which are farther away from the speaker. Okay. That clock. That Elmira. Okay. Those children. Okay, so here that and those are the words which are used for pointing out at things which are farther away from the speaker. Okay, so always remember that is used for pointing out at singular person, place or thing and those is used for pointing out at more than one person, place, animal or thing which are farther away from the speaker. So these are the things, children, which you need to keep in your mind, okay? Demonstrative adjectives, they always point out at person, place, animal or thing. They point out at certain person, place, animal or thing. They point out at noun in the sentence, okay? Then only they are said to be demonstrative adjectives, okay? Then they are this and these. Okay, they are used for pointing out at nouns which are nearer to the speaker, and that and those are used for pointing out at noun which are farther away from the speaker. Okay, and this and that for singular noun, and these and those for more than one person, place, animal or thing. So I hope this much is clear to you, children. So this is demonstrative. These four words are demonstrative adjectives. Okay. Now I am going to tell you the difference between demonstrative adjectives and demonstrative pronouns. Okay, though I have not taught pronouns yet, but I am going to tell you the difference. What is the difference between demonstrative adjectives and demonstrative pronoun? Okay, you will be able to understand very easily. Okay, I am going to give you a few examples to show you that what is the difference between demonstrative adjectives and demonstrative. So, I'm going to write you a few sentences and then I will make you understand that what is the difference between demonstrative adjectives and demonstrative pronouns. Now see. Now see, children, I have written two sentences here, okay, and then I am writing two more sentences here, okay. See, in the first and second sentence, children, that book is mine, this car is yours, okay. And in this sentence, that is your car and this is my pen. In all these four sentences, children, you may see that this, that, these and those. This, that is used here in these two sentences also. It's used here in these two sentences also. Okay. Now here I'm going to tell you that which one is demonstrative adjective and which one is demonstrative pronoun. Okay. As I told you that demonstrative adjectives, they always point out at certain person or thing. Now when we see the first two sentences, children, here in these two sentences, the word that and this, they are pointing at noun, okay? That book, this car, okay? So they are pointing out at noun, okay? So these two words here, that and this, they are demonstrative adjectives. Okay, because they are qualifying these two nouns here, book and car. These words, this and that in these two sentences, they are qualifying the noun. Okay, so here they are demonstrative adjective. Now let's see the other two sentences. That is your car and this is my pen. In these two sentences, the word that and this, they are not qualifying any noun. Instead, they are used in place of noun. Okay, and we know that words which are used in place of noun, they are called pronoun. So, here in these two sentences, they are demonstrative pronoun. They are demonstrative pronoun. Okay, so I hope, children, that difference is somewhat clear to you. Or suppose you are asked to pick out the demonstrative, you are asked to pick out the demonstrative adjectives, okay? So please do not get confused, okay? Words which means this, that, if they are this, that, these and those, they are for demonstrative words. If they are qualifying any noun in a sentence, then they are demonstrative adjective, okay? If they are placed in use, if they are used in place of noun, then they are demonstrative pronoun. Okay, So this is the difference between demonstrative adjective and demonstrative pronoun. And I hope the difference is also clear to you all. So children, these are the four kinds of adjectives. Okay. Now I'm going to solve few exercises which are given there in your book. Okay. I'll also give you definitions which you have to write down in your classwork copy. So let's see. So lesson number 8, the adjective. Okay, and I've told you what is an adjective and what are different kinds of adjectives. Adjectives have four kinds, okay? Adjectives of quality, quantity, number and demonstrative adjectives, okay? So now I'm going to start the exercises, okay? So the very first exercise given on page number 40, okay? Exercise A. And here in this exercise, you are asked to fill in the blanks with correct adjectives of quality. Select the words from the help list. As you can see, children, in this exercise, okay, one box is given there, okay, and all the adjectives are given there in the box. You have to choose the correct adjective and you have to fill these blanks. Okay, so let's start with the first sentence. The langur has a dash tail. Okay. We all know that adjectives of quality, they tells us about the kind of, what kind of person, place, animal or thing is. They tell us about their quality or about what kind of person, place, animal or thing is. Okay. So, the langur has a dash tail. What kind of tail langur has? Long tail. Langur has long tail. Now, the next sentence is, there is a dash well in our village. What kind of well? Deep well. What kind of well? Deep well. Okay. Then the next sentence is, always eat dash fruit. What kind of fruit should we eat? Fresh. Fresh fruit. Always eat fresh fruit. Now the next sentence is, the lion is a dash animal. What kind of animal is lion? Wild animal. Okay. Wild animal. The fifth sentence is, English is my dash subject. English is my favorite subject. English is my favorite subject. Okay. So all these words are telling us something about these nouns. Okay. And they are telling about their kind. What kind of person, place or animal or thing is. Okay. What kind of tail? Long tail. What kind of well? Deep well. What kind of fruit? Fresh fruit. What kind of animal? Wild animal. What kind of subject? Favorite. So these words, they are adjectives of quality because they are telling about the quality of noun. They are telling us about the quality of noun. Okay, so I hope this exercise A is clear to you all. Now let's move on to the next exercise, exercise B. Now here in this exercise, you are asked to pick out adjectives of quantity and adjectives of number in following sentences. I told you all that quantity, when we are talking about uncountable nouns, okay, then the adjective is adjectives of quantity. Okay, if adjective is talking about countable nouns, then it is adjective of numbers. Means uncountable nouns, they have quantity, and countable nouns, they have number. Okay, so we are going to start this exercise now. Now they have had enough exercise. Now see, exercise is noun here in the sentence, okay, which we cannot count. Exercise is uncountable noun. We cannot count the number of exercise. Okay. So here the word enough, which is telling us about something about the exercise, is what? It's adjective of quantity. It's adjective of quantity. Okay, now let's move on to the next sentence. There is some coffee in the flask. Now see here, coffee is noun here in the sentence. Okay, which is again uncountable noun. We cannot count coffee in numbers. Okay, so the word some here is what? It's an adjective, which an adjective of quantity. Adjective of quantity. Because we cannot count coffee in numbers. Okay. She did not eat any rice. Now rice, again here it's noun.
okay, which is uncountable. We cannot count rice in numbers, and the word any is telling us something about rice. So word any is adjective, and it is adjective of quantity. It is again adjective of quantity because we cannot count rice in number. It is uncountable noun. Okay, then the next sentence is most boys like cricket. Now see, here in this sentence, boys are noun, okay, and most is telling us something about these boys, okay, and we can count boys in numbers, okay, they are countable nouns, we can count them in numbers. So the word most is what? It's adjective of numbers. It is adjective of numbers. You can write N in bracket because we can count boys in numbers. It's countable noun. Okay. Then the next sentence. William Shakespeare wrote many dramas. We can count dramas in number. Okay. So the word many here is what? It's adjective of number. It's adjective of numbers. We can count dramas in number. He does not have much money. Now here word much is telling us something about money, which is noun, and it's an uncountable noun. So word much is what? It's adjective of quantity. It's adjective of quantity. Okay. Now the next sentence is there are 50 students in this classroom. Now see, the word 50 is telling us something about students, which is noun and which is countable noun. We can count students in number, okay? And the word 50 is number itself, so it is what? Adjective of numbers. It is adjective of numbers. You can write 50 here and bracket write down N. Okay? So in these 7 sentences, children, that you can see that the words, okay, the adjectives which are used before uncountable nouns, they are adjectives of quantity, okay? And adjectives which are used before countable nouns, they are adjective of numbers. Now let's move on to the other sentences, sentence number 8, 9 and 10. Now see here in this sentence, children, there is little hope of justice. Okay, so little, the word little is telling us something about hope, which is noun. It's an abstract noun and uncountable noun. We cannot count hope in numbers, okay? So this word little is adjective here and it is adjective of quantity. Why? Because hope cannot be counted in numbers. Okay, now, number 9. She committed several mistakes. We can count someone's mistakes in numbers. Okay. Mistakes is what? It's countable noun. Okay. And several is the word which is telling us something about the mistakes. So what? Several is what? It's adjective of number. Why? Because we can count someone's mistakes in number. Okay. It's countable noun and several is used before countable noun. So it's adjective of number. Okay. Then the last sentence is, step back 7 paces. Now see here in this exercise, in this sentence, the word 7 is telling us something about paces, okay, which is countable noun. Paces means kadam, okay. So paces can be counted in number, that's countable noun, and since it's used before countable noun, so it's adjective of number. It's adjective of number. Okay, so I hope this exercise B is also clear to you all. Now let's move on to the next exercise, that is exercise C. Pick out demonstrative adjectives and demonstrative pronouns in the following sentences. Now see here, children, in this exercise, you just now I've explained to you all that what is demonstrative adjectives and what is demonstrative pronouns. The word this, that, these, those, if they are used before nouns, they are demonstrative adjectives. Okay. If they are not used before nouns, they are demonstrative pronouns. Okay, so let's start with sentence number 1. This is my uncle. So the word this here is what? It's demonstrative pronoun. Why? Because it is not used before noun. Okay, the word this is not used before noun, so it's demonstrative pronoun. Okay, now the second sentence. These boys are very naughty. Now see here in this sentence, the word these is used before boys and these is qualifying boys. Okay, and boys is noun. So word these here is what? It's demonstrative adjective. It's demonstrative adjective. okay. Third sentence, that house is theirs. Okay, now here in this sentence also, the word that is used before house, which is noun. Okay, the word that is qualifying noun. So word that is what? Again, it's demonstrative adjective. Now let's move on to the fourth sentence. Those people are my neighbors. Okay, so here in this sentence, the word those again is used before people, which is noun. The word those is qualifying people. Okay, so this word is also what? The word those is what? It's demonstrative adjective. Okay, it's demonstrative adjective. And the last sentence is, that is a good picnic spot. Now you can see no noun is used, present there after that. Okay, that is not used, that is not qualifying any noun here in this sentence. So the word that is what? It's demonstrative pronoun. It's demonstrative pronoun. So I hope this exercise C is also clear to you all. Okay, and this exercise D we will not be doing in book, so you can put small cross here. We will not do this exercise in book. Okay, and the next exercise E also, joy drill also, we will not be doing, so you can put cross here also. Okay, we will not be doing this exercise also. So we have completed the exercises of lesson number 8, adjectives. Okay, now I'm going to start. Let's recall. Okay, let's recall 1. So we have completed let's recall 1. Exercise A and B we have already completed. Okay, so after completing lesson noun, we have completed exercise A. After completing noun gender, we have completed exercise B. And today, since we have completed the exercises of adjectives, so today we are going to do this exercise number D. Okay, we will not be doing C1. After completing interrogative pronouns only, we will do this exercise. Okay, so today we will start exercise D of let's recall 1. Okay, and here in this exercise, you are asked to fill in the blanks using the correct adjectives. Okay, now see children, if option is not given there, okay, you can write down correct adjectives. You can write it by your own also, okay, but it should be correct. Now see, first sentence is, Sanskrit is a dash language to learn. Okay, so here I am writing difficult language to learn. Okay, if you write easy, then also it's correct. Okay, easy is also correct, difficult is also correct. Second sentence, we must eat dash vegetables. We must eat fresh vegetable is also correct. If you write green, then also it's correct. Okay, both answers are correct. Here difficult is also correct, easy is also correct. Okay, so any one you can write, no need to write down both the answers here. Okay, I'm giving you options so that you may select any one of them and write in your book. Okay, no need to write both the answers. Okay, now let's move on to the next sentences. Now here, third sentence is, Agra is a dash city. Okay, so you have to use adjective. So you can write down big also, Agra is a big city, or Agra is a beautiful city. Okay, you can write down any of the big or beautiful, means both are correct. You can write any of them. He ate dash porridge. Okay, he ate hot porridge, cold porridge, tasty porridge, both are correct. Okay, any of them you can write, it's correct. This region had an dash rainfall this year. So this region had an. Now this article an is used here. So you have to use a word which starts with vowel. Okay, so this region had an. Okay, so this we will do afterwards. Let's move on to the next one. Sixth one. He told us an dash a story. Now see, the word, if word an is used, article an is used. So here you should use a word which starts with vowel. So he told us an interesting story. He told us an interesting story. Okay. Now, seventh one. He has dash friends. He has many friends. He has less friends. Okay, both are correct. Ashoka was a dash king. Ashoka was a great king. Ashoka was a brave king. Or means both are correct. You can write any of them. Ninth one. My uncle bought a dash car. My uncle bought a new car, my uncle bought a latest car, my uncle bought a big car, my uncle bought a small car, all are correct. Okay, my uncle bought a toy car. Okay, no, toy is not an adjective. My uncle bought a new car or big car, okay, or small car, you can write, or latest car. The 10 sentences, she sang a dash song. She sang a beautiful song. She sang a beautiful song, you can write. Okay, now this 5th sentence is your homework. Try to find it out and do it by yourself. Okay, which adjective you will use here, which starts with article A-E-I-O-U. Why? Because article an is used here. Okay, so here you have to use word that starts with vowel A-E-I-O-U. Okay, so all the 10 sentences I have done for you all. This one I'm giving you as your homework. Okay, try to find out. Got it, children? So I hope you all have understood this exercise also. Okay, let's recall D you need to do in your book. Okay, so please complete your work till here. Okay, after completing your book exercise, you will write down this definition in your classwork copy. Only one definition you have to write. Okay, give heading properly and underline it with blue pencil color, then write down the definition. An adjective is a word that adds something to the meaning of a noun. Okay, two examples I have given here and adjectives you have to underline. Okay, and then this you will write down. There are four kinds of adjectives. Okay, and then names of all four kinds of adjectives you have to write down. Adjectives of quality, adjectives of quantity, adjectives of number, demonstrative adjectives. So only one definition you have to write down. Okay, and all the four kinds of adjectives you have to write down in your classwork copy.
So I hope, children, you all have understood the exercises. Okay, so please complete all your book and copy work. Okay, whatever exercises were given to you, whatever copy work was given to you, please complete it, children. Okay, and today we have completed the portion of our first semester. Okay, so start preparing yourself for your first semester examination, children. Okay, and yes, very soon you will be provided with the syllabus as well as the portion for your first semester examination. Now see, children, I'm going to tell you the summer assignment. Okay, summer assignments you have to do in your classwork copy. After completing all your copy work, means after completing the definition of adjectives which I have given to you, after completing that work, you have to start summer assignment work. Okay, you will do it in your copy itself, in your classwork copy. Okay, and I'm going to tell you that how you have to do, okay, the summer assignments and what are the questions given in your summer assignments. Okay, only two questions I have given. Both questions are very easy. Okay, so, and both questions are already taught, means I have given those questions from the lessons which I have already taught to you all. Okay, so please complete, children, all your work neatly in good handwriting. So let's see how you have to do your summer assignment in your classwork copy.
Okay, so children, I'm going to tell you that how you have to do summer assignment in your classwork copy. Now suppose you have completed definition of adjective on this page. Okay, now this page is vacant, so no need to start your summer assignment work from this page. Okay, leave this page. Okay, you will leave this page after completing. Suppose if you have completed on this page, then okay, it's okay, you can start summer assignment from this page. But suppose if you have completed your work till here, means till this page you have finished your work and this page is vacant, so no need to start your summer assignment from this page. Okay, you will turn the page. Okay, and at the left hand side you will give the heading summer assignment like this. Okay, no drawings, no pictures, nothing should be there on in your classwork copy. Okay, simple heading is enough with blue pencil color and underline it with blue pencil color. That's it. Okay, don't decorate the page, don't make your copy dirty. It's your classwork copy. Okay, after giving this heading, children, you can start your summer assignment homework. You all know that only two questions are given to you all. Okay, in English 1 summer assignment. Okay, so the first question is, arrange the words given below in alphabetical order. You can see how I have written and I have underlined this question with blue pencil color. Okay, then you will copy down all the 10 words given there. Okay, and then you will draw a line like this, okay? And now on this side, you will arrange these words in alphabetical order, okay? You have drawn line. So this side, you will arrange all these words in alphabetical order, okay? So first question, you will do like this. Then second question is, write feminine forms of the words given below. Okay, 10 words are given there, 10 masculine words are given there. So you will make two columns, one for masculine and the other one for feminine. Okay, you will write down all the masculine words in one column here. Then you will draw a line and you will write down the feminines on the other side. Okay, so I hope how you have to do your summer assignment work is clear to you all. So please do it neatly in good handwriting. Summer assignment carries 10 marks. Okay, so please do it sincerely. So I hope children, you all have understood that how you have to complete your summer assignments in your classwork copy. Okay, please do it sincerely children, because it carries 10 marks. Okay, and which will be added in your first semester examination. Okay, so please do it neatly in good handwriting. So from today onwards children, enjoy your holidays. Okay. And please don't forget to spend some time on your studies as well, because 1 month is there for you all. Okay. Prepare yourself for your first semester examination. Complete all your work. And hopefully we will meet in July. Okay. So thank you. And yes, enjoy your holidays. Thank you.